Oh, hello again, people. Up in front of the camera today, we can see that Variac once again. And in today's video, we are going to be looking at how to soft start a Variac with a light bulb. Yep, you guessed it, people. We are going to soft start that Variac with a light bulb. Okay, here's how we're going to do it. Okay, let's go look at the floor in the room and see what we've got set up, people. Here we go. Well, once again, we've got that Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit there, which is just waiting to go. And this is how we're going to soft start a Variac with a light bulb, okay? Now, in another video, right, because this is basically essentially a revisit of how to soft start things. In another video, I soft started that Variac with using a fan heater, which involved masses of wires and whatnot, and it was all a bit cumbersome, wasn't it? So I've been looking at trying to simplify the layout and make it easier to connect up and not have rolls of wire lying around all over the place. So here's what we got in our setup today. In this video, we're going to soft start that Variac with that light bulb. Okay, to start with, we need a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, which will help us to soft start our Variac there. Here's our main supply coming in. Okay, main supply that is currently live. Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, that's all we need. Main supply, Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit, and of course, follow that all the way around. It goes to our Variac. That's all we need. Okay. We've even got a bypass plug on there, look. So we don't need an extra roll of wire with a plug on one end and shorted out connections on the other, because it's all done inside that plug. Okay, that's the bypass plug, okay. So there it is. We don't even need to worry about that anymore, because we've got the bypass plug. Instead of having a plug with a load of wire sticking out of it, and the ends of that are shorted together, all of that is done inside there. So that's been simplified as well. So, how do I get that light bulb in there? Because that is where it's going to go. That light bulb is going to go in that side of the Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit. And the Variac is going to go in that side. Okay, so that's how we're going to do it. But how do I get that plugged in there? Well, we're going to need a plug. Okay, and on the end of that, we've got a bayonet socket. Okay. Nice little thing I've made up there. That's nice for testing out light bulbs, that is. But we're going to use it to soft start that Variac. Now then, those two plugs, we can only get one of those in there at a time. Oh dear. That is where this comes in. It's a power cube. Okay. So what we're going to do, first of all, we're going to put that into our Fun-Jiggery-Pokery Unit. Just like as it was previously. Okay. And then that will allow us to put our load delimiter in, which is going to be a light bulb. In it goes. Like that. Okay, and we screwed the light bulb in there. So that is going to be our load limiter. I just got to set the camera down a minute, people. Hold on. There we go. So that's now plugged in there. There's our load limiter, which is going to restrict the inrush on that Variac. Like so. And then we just take our supply for our Variac and put it in that side, like so. Okay, in it goes. Turn that on, and we turn that on. Okay, next up, making sure that the Variac is turned off. Okay, that Variac is turned off. That's on zero. We're not going to be concerning ourselves with any loads on the Variac, okay? All we're doing is looking at getting that soft started using a light bulb. Okay. Now then, You're probably wondering, does that light bulb actually light up during the startup? Well, yes, it does. It's occasionally, it depends from what I found, where the sine wave is, where the AC sine wave is, as you turn the Variac on. Because sometimes when I turn that on, that light bulb will stay as it currently is, and then it just lights up a nice dim glow. And then sometimes when I turn the Variac on, that'll let out a reasonable sort of yellowish sort of flash, and then it'll dim down to a nice warm glow. And then when I put the bypass plug in, because that's obviously then bypassed, that light bulb then goes out as it currently is. Okay, so next up, let's get our power supply plugged on. So we're just going to remove the dust protection cap. There we go. That's now off. And that's what's inside there. Okay. So there we go. Let's just turn those switches off for now, because we're going to plug our supply on there. Okay. So that is going to go on there, like that. Just hold that down with our foot. Okay, that's now live on there. So there we go. And now we turn our load restrictor on, like that, and the Variac. Okay, now when I turn that Variac on, what that Variac wants to do is pull as much current as it can, as fast as it can, in the shortest amount of time possible. Okay, but we're going to restrict it with a 60 watt light bulb. Okay, it's a standard filament light bulb, that, and it's 60 watts, and that will allow that Variac to start up, but it will dramatically reduce the inrush. Okay, so much so, in fact, that in my bedroom, when I try to power that up, it makes my 16 amp circuit breaker pop. Okay, and I've got to use this technique if I want to start up my Variac in my bedroom, because the Variac makes the circuit breaker pop, and it's a 16 amp type 1. The British standard 3871 is the circuit breaker, and it just goes pop every time. So I've got to use this technique, this soft starting technique, every time I want to start my Variac up in my bedroom, because the circuit breaker just will not have it. And yeah, so I've got the setup as I would here in my bedroom. And now we're going to switch that Variac on and soft start it with the light bulb. And then once that's fluxed up, what we're then going to do is get our bypass plug, plop it in there, and then that will get the full current. Okay, I might also like to point out as well, if you attempt to use the Variac without the bypass plug in, because the light bulb holds back the Variac, it restricts it. Okay, I don't know whether the restriction would damage the Variac. Okay, so it's always worth noting that you must ensure that you've bypassed the soft starter before you put a load on the Variac. So I'm going to get our keys now, and I'm going to power up that Variac. Now, because there's a possibility of that light bulb doing a nice little flash, depending on how I catch the AC sine wave as I start it, what I'm going to do is, as I turn that on, I'm going to have this camera on that light bulb, and you can see whether it does the little flash or not, because sometimes it does, sometimes it don't, and I've got the video camera here, so it'd be nice to see whether or not we can catch that inrush on video. Okay, if I do catch it at the appropriate point in the AC sine wave, we'll see that light bulb do a nice little warm orangey flash, and then it'll settle down, and you'll just barely see the filament glowing there. I don't know if you actually see the filament glowing in there, because I've already got the bedroom light turned on. Okay, it's normally quite faint, but you do see it start up, do the little flash when I turn the Variac on. So here we go. I will try and do it, do the Variac a couple of times, just so that we get that little flash on camera. Okay, so here we go, people. In 3, 2, 1. Okay, the Variac is on, people. Okay. Oh, I believe it is anyway. Just let me listen to it a minute. Just let me go check the wall socket a minute, people. Hold on. Okay, people, the wall socket was on, but no glow from that light bulb. I say we try again. I've turned the Variac off. Let's try and get a little flash on that light bulb. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Yay! Did you see that little flash then? It just lit up really sort of very quickly and very dimly. That was a 10 amp Variac doing a little bit of inrush on a 60 watt light bulb. Let's see if I can do it again, because normally speaking I can get it to do it a few times, and yeah, sometimes if I catch the AC sine wave at the right point at the right time, that light bulb does flash quite well. Here we go. Nope, not that time. Let's turn it off. Let's try again. No, it doesn't want to do it now. Sometimes it does, you know, it depends whether I get the Variac turned on at the right point in the AC sine wave. No, it's not doing it now, people. But anyway, I did get it, managed to get it on camera at the point that, when it does the little flash. Okay, let's give it a couple more times, and then if I don't get the flash again, at least I've got it sort of on camera. I know what I should do. I should turn the bedroom light out. Okay, let's put the keys in the Variac. We'll turn the bedroom light out and see if we can get maximum effect on that light bulb. Okay, right. I can still see the light bulb, but the camera can't. So, the camera is now right onto the light bulb. Here we go, people. Nope, still nothing. But that camera is right on that light bulb. Okay. Give it a few more times. You never know. I just might get this. And 3, 2, 1. Nah, it's not having it, people. I can see that very dimly light up. But the camera is just not getting it. Let's try again. No, it's just not catching it, people. And also, I cannot seem to, it seems to me that when it does do the little flash, it's, you know, it's just a matter of a fluke, you know. It's, I don't know when or where the sine wave is. So, it's just, when it does it, it's just a stroke of luck, really. But here we go. Let's see if I can do it a couple more times. No, but it is proving that it does soft start that Variac quite nicely. Oh yes, did you see that then? That was a nice little flash just then, just after 14 minutes, okay? So wind the video back at 14 minutes and then press the play button and you'll see it do a nice little flash. Okay, the camera did catch it that time, which proves my point. Let's turn the bedroom light on, people. Right, so, I've got the Variac turned on now. Okay, and if I was going to use that at that point, what I would do now is I would take our bypass plug, plug that in there like that, and now that's plugged in, that light bulb is now bypassed, okay, which means I can remove it. Okay, that's now removed, and because the bypass plug is in there, that Variac is now getting the top voltage and the top current. Okay, and that is now ready for use. And I can put a load on there without making any fuses or circuit breakers pop people because of Inrush. And that is how you start up a Variac with a light bulb. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that, and I'm glad I did manage to get that little flash on camera, because that is quite nice. Okay, people, thanks for watching.